you've kind of been, I'd say, the poster child of the program, if you will. When Sean Marks or Kenny Atkinson talk about people who've bought in, who've developed, they would always talk about you, both on and off the court. Now, obviously, you're going to be here for the long haul with the contract you just signed. I mean, how gratifying has this journey been, and how much pride do you take in kind of being one of those foundational guys that has led this new wave of Brooklyn Nets basketball?
It's been super fun. You know, this was kind of the vision from day one. You know, when I got drafted, I remember talking to Sean and Kenny on the phone and talking about, you know, 3-4 years down the line, what we can be, what we can become as a team and individually, you know, the goals that I have for myself. And I feel like I'm on the right path, and there's still more to accomplish.
Caris, what about, you know, your approach to this summer? You played extraordinary basketball through the postseason and through the playoffs, and we saw you really, as you came back from injury, playing some of the best basketball that we've seen. What has been, what's your summer been like, and how have you tried to take your game now to another level as you enter this season?
I think for me, I tried to, you know, just improve on, you know, where I left off on. Definitely my confidence was super high going into the offseason. I tried to just build off of that, you know, tried to see how good I can actually get at this game. I feel like when you do certain things on the court, you kind of know how good you are. And I tried to push myself to be elite, you know, this summer. And, you know, going forward, that's my mindset.
You know, along those lines, I think a lot of times when people see a developing player and they see positive returns, you start projecting, well, he could be like this, you know, he could be this kind of player. Do you in your mind have sort of a standard? Is it I want to be a perennial all-star? Is it I know I can be all NBA? I mean, what is it for you that you envision for yourself?
I don't try to put limits on it, to be honest with you. So, you know, I try to be the best player I can be, whether that's all-star, superstar, you know, Hall of Fame even. I try not to put any limits on it and attack every day, you know, trying to be the best player I can be.
What about the leadership role that we talked to Sean, we talked to Kenny, and they've always pointed at you as a guy who's been an extraordinary example of how you work. You got a few new pieces, and you've lost some different players that were great leaders in the locker room. What do you do in terms of really trying to take the reins of a leadership role along with some of these other guys?
I think naturally I'm just kind of a guy who leads by example, you know, shows the work that I put in, and people kind of just see that naturally. And obviously with these guys coming in with more experience, I'm more excited to learn from them, learn from what they have to say, you know, learn from the way that they work. And I can't wait to take the floor with those guys.
All right. So you've had this relationship with Kevin Durant to a certain degree for a while now. Caris, give us some insight into the kind of teammate you know he's going to be for you.
It's going to be huge, huge for my development, huge for the team. You know, anytime you get a guy who, you know, finals MVP, you know, they have a lot of knowledge. They've been in a lot of big games, played in a lot of big moments. So for that, it's going to be huge. It's going to be huge for us.
John and Musa looking for some camera time there.
I know. He didn't realize that he wasn't getting a chance to get in just yet. New backcourt mate, Kyrie Irving. Describe what you feel like the play and how the play between you two will be a little bit different than what you had last year, and the ways in which you're looking to find some synergy with him.
I think it'll be honestly really similar. You know, I feel like we're a team who kind of utilizes the backcourt, utilizes, you know, mismatches in the backcourt that we have. And obviously Kyrie's going to pose a lot of those mismatches for the other team. So I feel like playing off of each other will be huge for us. And then learning from him as well. You know, the summer's been huge for us, just building chemistry and things like that.
There's so much excitement around this. And, you know, obviously the job changes a little bit for Kenny Atkinson as well. You know, it goes from a team with developing young talent to all of a sudden a team with great expectations. Knowing Kenny's style the way that you do, how do you think it's going to mesh with Kyrie and Kevin and the way that they want to play? You know, they were just talking about that was one of the appeals to them and why they came here.
I think they'll love Kenny. You know, he's a really competitive coach, someone who, you know, kind of pulls the best out of each player. And he's a player's coach, you know, just from his background being, you know, on that side of things. So, like I said, I think they'll love Kenny. I think they'll love the organization, everyone surrounding it. And it'll be a great experience.
There's so much buzz, as we can see here on Media Day, a little different than it's been the past few seasons. But you guys get to work tomorrow. And I know you've been in the gym and you've all been here together. But training camp actually officially begins tomorrow. For you, does it feel different? Is there a different feel as you head into this preseason?
I think so, definitely. You know, to say there isn't would be definitely a lie. You know, we definitely have different caliber of players on the team this year, you know, championship level guys. So that'll be huge. That'll be fun going into training camp. And I can't wait to get started this year.